Yeah. Hello. Good evening, children. Good evening, all of you. Yeah, you are heartedly waiting for the session. I know all of you are very bright students. Yes. Yes. Hello, Umesh, Anshika Rai. Very good. Good evening. And tomorrow, children, I am taking a session on our beginning of the new batches, and you will come to know that how you can enroll in the new batches. Yeah. So tomorrow, yeah, we'll be there. So let's start today's session. Today is the science session. Yesterday we had maths, and today the science session will be completing NSO 2019 paper. So good evening to all of you. Welcome, dear children. Reenu ma'am welcomes you in this session. And let's start upon the question number one. Yeah, which of the following statements are correct? Is or are correct? In neutralization reaction, heat is always given out. Yes, phenolphthalein remains colorless in a window cleaner solution. Tooth decay is caused by the presence of calcium salts. And on diluting an acid, we should always add water to the acid. So, which one of the statements is correct? Come on. Which one of the following is correct or are correct? Come on. I hope all of you have seen it. In your notebooks, write down neutralization reaction, heat is given out. Phenolphthalein remains colorless in the window cleaner solution. Tooth decay is caused by the presence of calcium salts. On dilute an acid, we should always add water to the acid. We should always add water. You have to tell which is the correct one. Which is the correct one? Yes, waiting for your answers. Waiting for the live. Okay. Which one is correct? Anshika Rai says A, Sadik says D, Umesh says D, and answer is C. Only first is correct. Neutralization reaction is an exothermic process, so there's evolution of heat. Tooth decay is caused by increasing acidic content, not because of calcium. Calcium to helpful hai for teeth. And dilution in of acid may we add acid to water, not water to acid. So only the first statement is correct. Very good. So let's move on to next question. Let's move on to the next question. When air is passed through red hot coke, a gaseous fuel is produced. The name of the gaseous fuel and its composition are respectively. Natural gas is, 1 minute. Natural gas is CH4. It's methane, carbon dioxide, hydrogen, or producer gas, that is nitrogen and carbon monoxide. You all are saying water gas because you have heard only about water gas, but actually, when red hot coke, a gaseous fuel is produced, the name of the gases and composition respectively, producer gas, nitrogen, and CO. Yes, Aditya. So please remember that. Anshubhi Dwivedi is right. It is nitrogen and CO. When air is passed through red hot coke, a gaseous fuel is produced known as producer gas, which is a mixture of carbon monoxide and nitrogen gas, as coke is oxidized to carbon dioxide. Right? Next, study the given table carefully and fill in the blanks by selecting an appropriate option. Fill in the blanks by selecting an appropriate option. Copper vessel exposed to moist air. Product formed first coating of what turns red litmus solution to blue. The copper vessel exposed to moist air, it turns red litmus to blue. That means it is basic in nature. So what can be first? Okay. Now, ma'am, please, I just got free batch phase two. Okay, very good. Very good, Sadiq. Congratulations. All those children who did well enrolled, they are getting the second phase batch free of cost. Very good. Yeah, Kushi, you can come to us in VOS. You can join the classes there. Yes, Rudashi, it is green, but what is the name? Aluminium foil dipped in fresh solution of NaOH. Aluminium plus NaOH. Which gas will be formed which burns with dash? Come on. Yes. Rusting of iron, reddish brown deposit turns. Reddish brown deposit turns. Burning of sulfur powder, sulfur in oxygen, which gas? turns blue litmus solution to red. That means it is acidic in nature. Now let's see. First is red, green, brown or green. It is green. So you select green wale options. Second is, it is hydrogen gas. Sodium aluminate banega isme. Sodium aluminate plus hydrogen. So hydrogen burns with a pop sound. So which is the second one where hydrogen burns with the pop sound? So aapka option hi yahi par clear ho gaya that it is D option. Agar aap third or fourth option nahi bhi padho. Third is rusting of iron turns red litmus to blue. Yes, because it's red litmus to blue. And next is sulfur dioxide turns blue litmus to red. It is suffocating gas. So SO2. So fourth option is correct. D. Very good. So now all of you know, and this green substance is verdigris. It is basic copper carbonate. Copper hydroxide and copper carbonate. Basic copper carbonate. Umesh Joshi, if you're an outsider and you want to enroll in batch, then you have to, I will be taking a session tomorrow. There is an ID where which you have to click, and after clicking on that, you will get the batches. Yeah. If anybody can share the ID over here, one of my old students can share the ID over here. Yeah, just now I will not be able to pick it up. So you add that. Click on that, Umesh. Join the session tomorrow, how to join in the new batches. And then you will get the course for ₹2,700 only for 5 months, which amounts to only ₹20 per class, because there will be nearly 120 classes. We'll be covering the entire syllabus. So this is the reaction. This is all I've discussed with you. Next comes. Given below is the list of few chemicals that are used for the protection of crops. First is Delapon. Second is Butachlor. Third, Malathion, Cimazine, Dicistone, Gamaxine. How many of these are used as? 1 minute, it is not clear. So I'll just make it brief. Yeah, I'll just make it brief. How many of these are used as herbicides? Yeah, which option? Third. See, let us see. It is used as an herbicide, act on the perennial grasses, controls a specific weed. Delapon species, leaving the desired crops relatively unharmed. Butachlor, it is used in herbicide, mainly used in form of granules in rice. Malathion is used as insecticide. Cimazine is again herbicide. Dicistone, insecticide. It is used as an agricultural insecticide and pharmaceutical purpose. Right. So you had to tell which few are used for the protection of the crops. So out of these, which are, how many of them are used as herbicides? So Delapon is a herbicide. Sorry. Remember, Delapon is an herbicide. Butachlor is an herbicide. Cimazine is an herbicide. So there are three herbicides out of these. Next comes, the given graph shows, very important question again, which you will find only in Olympiads. Various factors, pick of the day, hai ye, element N present in the water body after the sewage is discharged. This was the river flowing. यहां पर इस पॉइंट पर सीवेज डिस्चार्ज कर दिया. अभी तक वाटर का लेवल कांस्टेंट था. जैसे सीवेज डिस्चार्ज किया, एल इंक्रीजेस ड्रास्टिकली, बहुत इंक्रीज हो गया. एक कोई नंबर था विच हैज डिक्रीज्ड, एन एंड एम. सो व्हाट आर दीज एल एम एन कुड बी. ड्रॉ दिस डायग्राम. कौन बढ़ गया और कौन कम हो गया आफ्टर द सीवेज डिस्चार्ज. For a guess idea, I can tell you, when sewage is discharged, the bacteria increase because they decompose the sewage. So L could be the bacteria. What is this which is decreasing? M and N could be what? So you have to tell incorrect. L could be bacteria which increases tremendously water due to addition of sewage. Very good. Okay. M correspond to biological oxygen demand. Sadik, there is no, like you can say ki is class ka nahi pata, ye neat mein bhi aise hi question aa jaye, because general topics are there in medical bio also. Agar aap bio ka neat ka paper dekhoge to 10 questions aap fir bhi answer kar doge, aap bologe to humne 7th 8th mein padha hai. N could be aquatic animals which die on account of non availability of oxygen. Yes. M correspond to biological oxygen demand, which decreases due to accumulation of sewage and water. M is oxygen demand, which decreases due to sewage in water. That will never decrease. This is wrong. This is correct. Fishes die. So both A and C incorrect. Nahin, absolutely wrong. Both A and C are correct. So this is incorrect. Understood? Very good. So let's proceed to question number 5. Quiz number 5. This was the solution. When the sewage is discharged into river, the number of bacteria increases. At the same time, the marine life decreases. So additional sewage water decreases the dissolved oxygen water, which increases its biological oxygen demand. It increases its biological demand. Isme likha tha, it decreases the biological oxygen demand. Right. Next is quiz number 6. P, Q, R, S in the given Venn diagram and select the option. P are the organisms which respire through skin, R through lungs, Q through gills. So Q are fishes, very much clear. Through skin can be worms, through lungs can be mammals, reptiles, frog also. And S is skin and lungs, frog. So now you see, P could be frog, P could be monkey to ho hi nahi sakta, cancel ho gaya. P could be hydra, earthworm. Hydra bhi nahi hota because it is through the water canal system. So you have to choose between A and C. Q could be grasshopper. Q is what? Through gills. So grasshopper does not breathe through gills. So which is your answer? Option C. Sometimes you may not know all the options, but you eliminate ki ye nahi ho sakta, ye nahi ho sakta. Therefore, this is the answer. And I told you, S to ho sakta because it breathes through lungs and skin both. Q is salmon, R is dolphin. Right. Next, earthworms do not have lungs. Instead, they breathe through the skin. Salmon-like fish breathe through gills. Unlike fish who breathe through, dolphins breathe air using lungs. And the frog has 3 respiratory surfaces in the body that it uses, skin, lungs, and the lining of the mouth. Move on to the next question. Come on, fast, quick. Match column 1 with column 2 and select the correct option very fast. We are about to reach midway. Typhoid causative agent is bacteria or virus or protozoa. It spreads through contaminated water, wound, air, direction contact, contaminated food. Measles. I took a complete lecture on diseases on YouTube. Hai. Yes, complete lecture on diseases I took. I hope many of you attended also. Polio, you note down and then you match from the next page and then dysentery. First, you note down your options. Typhoid is bacterial, measles is viral, polio is viral, dysentery is protozoan. Now, let's see which options. P matches with A and Q with B. P matches with A in these two options. So you have to select with out of these. Now Q matches with B in both. Okay. R matches with B in what? RB. Ye bhi theek hai. Sorry. And then S matches with C. Now comes which one? Bacteria. It spreads through what? Typhoid spreads through what? 1 and 5, water and air. Then Q, which is the another one? Measles, through air and direct contact. Next, polio. Yeah, polio R, through 1 and 5, contaminated water and contaminated food. And dysentery, S is 1 and 5. Yeah. So what is your next? So see, dysentery is a protozoan disease caused by Entamoeba histolytica and spreads by contaminated food and water. By contaminated food and water, fecal-oral route, droplets or direct contact spreads through contaminated food and water. So this is about diseases. Children, please go to my session of diseases. That was very, very important. You will find bacterial disease, protozoan diseases over there. Next question. Very good. All of you, yes, Yashika, okay, you have joined VOS, very good, welcome you all. And viewers, you all are very excited about the second phase batch. I know about it. Pew wanted to study two different plants, X and Y, among many plants that were planted in her garden. She watered them regularly and took care of them, both plant flowers, but after some days, Pew noticed that only X yielded fruits, whereas fruit setting was absent in plant Y. What could be the reason? X mein fruits hue, Y mein nahi hue. So Y could be male, X is female because fruits are bared by female. Now let's see what are they saying. X is insect pollinated, Y is wind, X is dioecious, whereas Y is monoecious. Dioecious means sexes separate and Y monoecious means male female dono. Nahi, ye sirf male hai to ye dioecious hai. Ye female ya male female dono ho sakta hai. So what will be your answer? X bears only unisex egg. Y present Pew's garden could be dioecious male plant. What could be your answer? What could be your answer? Waiting for your answer here. This question might confuse you in the exams if you don't today attend the class with me. Yeah. What could be your answer here? Yes, Rodashi. Very much right. Y is dioecious male plant. Why is dioecious male plant? इसमें pollination insect से हुआ, wind से हुआ, उससे फर्क नहीं पड़ता. Why male है इसलिए flowers fruits नहीं हुआ. X में X could produce fruits because either it is having male and female both or it's only female. So X could be monoecious plant which contain both male and female or it could be only female. Whereas Y must be a dioecious male plant which could not produce food as it does not possess female reproductive structure. Next question is, the given figure shows position of few endocrine glands in human body. Two patients, Karan and Ali, recently visited an endocrinologist. Endocrine glands are the ductlets glands in your body, out of which pituitary is the main gland. They do not have ducts to secrete their hormones. They secrete their hormones in the blood. So doctor, those who treat the hormonal treatment जो करते हैं उनको बोलते हैं endocrinologist. Doctor examiner prepared a chart here to record of their illness and monitor their health. Now see, P here, Q in throat, R, S. All of you can make out. अभी digestive system पढ़ा है सब लोगों ने. सब बता सकते हैं ये क्या है. Yes, hypothalamus पर, which gland is there? Yes, come on. Very good. Guess. Which gland is over here? Yes. Which causes? Yeah. Karan. Patient's name is swollen neck. Karan ka swollen neck hai. Ali, large quantities of sugar in blood and urine. Yes. Very good. Karan ka swollen neck hai. Toh which gland? Thyroid gland. And which is that? Q. So refer to the figure and chart and select the correct statement. Condition of Karan and Ali. अली का शुगर आ रहा है ब्लड में. दिस इज व्हाट पैंक्रियास. सो लेट अस सी. करण इज सफरिंग फ्रॉम गोइटर व्हिच इज कॉज्ड ड्यू टू हाइपोसिक्रीशन ऑफ हार्मोन बाय ग्लैंड क्यू. ग्लैंड क्यू यू हैव टू टेल व्हिच इज करेक्ट. ओके. एली इज सफरिंग फ्रॉम डायबिटीज व्हिच इज कॉज्ड ड्यू टू हाइपोसिक्रीशन ऑफ हार्मोन बाय ग्लैंड आर. आई विल शो यू आर. Karan is suffering from albinism, which is caused by hyposecretion of hormone by gland P. Ali is suffering from diabetes, which is caused by hyposecretion of S. Or both A and B are correct. Very good, Riya. Both A and B are correct. Kitna achha question banaya hai. Yes. What happened? What happened? Listen, excuse me. It is here. Yes, Q represents thyroid gland. A goiter is swelling in the cotton from here. A goiter is a swelling of the thyroid gland that causes the lump in the front of the neck. Therefore, Karan must be suffering from goiter. R represents pancreas. Diabetes mellitus is a group of metabolic disorders characterized by high blood sugar level caused by hyposecretion of insulin hormone from pancreas. Therefore, Ali must be suffering from diabetes. Very good. Very good question it was. Study the given flow chart and select the correct option. Kitna interesting hai chalo, ma'am ke saath aap 20 questions kar loge, otherwise pending rahega. Aur aapko आंसर्स का एक्सप्लेनेशन नहीं मिलता है व्हेन यू डू इट. आप देखते हो आपने गलत कर दिया, ओ ओके करेक्ट आंसर इज दिस, बट यू डोंट गेट क्लैरिफिकेशन. व्हेन यू गेट क्लैरिफिकेशन यू रिमेंबर. सो जस्ट इन 5 to 10 minutes वी विल फिनिश इट. प्लांट प्रोपगेट्स वेजिटेटिवली बाय रूट्स, वेजिटेटिवली बाय लीव्स. लीव से कौन होता है? बोगनविलिया. रूट से या देयर आर मेनी प्लांट्स, सो जस्ट रूट से बताओ. डेलिया, एस्परेगस, बिगोनिया, स्वीट पोटेटो. And why is its begonia, bougainvillea, onion, strawberry? Come on. Yes. Dahlia is by bulbs. So which propagates by roots? Come on. So which option is correct? Option B is correct. Dahlia propagates by bulbs. Okay. It is asparagus and begonia. Bougainvillea nahi. Bougainvillea doesn't propagate by leaves. It's begonia and bryophyllum by leaves. Asparagus is herbaceous perennial plant, can be propagated by seed or through root. Begonia propagate through leaf cuttings, unlike other plants that use stem portions for reproduction. So, begonia uses its leaf veins to create new plantlets, even bryophyllum also. Identify the parts labeled. I really love this Olympiads mein bio ke questions. They give it in such a good manner that child can easily get confused, but it really sharpens your skills, and these are also the kind of questions you get in NTSC or in 10th board objective. Identify the parts labeled as P to T in the given figure and select the option statement, correct statement regarding them. See, this is which part? A big part where digestion, this is which part, and select the correct statement regarding them. P to T, reproductive organs. Yeah, this is what are P and T. It looks to be the male reproductive organ. I've given you the hint. Yeah. The part labeled as P, I will show you the diagram again and again. Produce, you have to tell which of the statement is correct. Produces male gametes, and the part labeled S produces androgen. Okay. Part labeled S produces androgen. The sperm collects and mature in the part R. See, do the sperms collect in part R? Next, parts P and R have no role in reproduction. Part T is located outside the abdominal cavity and protects P and Q. T is located outside the abdominal cavity and protects P and Q inside it. So you had to tell which one is the correct statement. Part T is located. Now see, look at this diagram. This is big. This is the urinary bladder. This is ureter. Ye body ki cavity thi. Ye rectum, seminal vesicle, prostate gland, vas deferens, scrotum, testes, urethra, penis, erectile tissue. Now see, T scrotum, it is a bag of skin that holds and protects the testicles. Testicles make sperm, and to do this, the temperature of the testicles need to be cooler than inside of the body. That is why the scrotum is located outside the body. This is the hanging part in the males, which is outside the body, because it keeps the testicles cool. So option D was correct. So it was a tricky question. It could go wrong. Because in schools you just get, okay, draw the diagram of male productive organ. Or they can say, describe the function of vas deferens, this. Or they can say where the sperms are produced. So straight questions you get. But here they twist the questions, and unless and until you practice such questions, you can't do them correct. Refer to the given table and select the correct option regarding PQR. Come on, let's go fast. Growing in nitrogen deficient soil, plant. Which can grow in nitrogen deficient soil? It can be leguminous plants, because leguminous plants do not need nitrogen in the soil. They enrich the soil with nitrogen. Next is Q is the plant which is leafless and rootless. That is plant Q. Now, it's leaves and roots. Third is prepare its carbohydrate through photosynthesis. That is plant P and R. Okay. So let us see. Now they are asking, correct, select the correct statement regarding PQR. P possesses special root-like structures called haustoria for the absorption of nitrogen from the atmospheric air. Plant Q could catch and digest insects and show completely heterotrophic mode of nutrition. Plant Q. Q, leafless and rootless. R could be, prepares its carbohydrates through photosynthesis. R could be Nepenthes or Rafflesia. P could be Nepenthes, where Q could be, jinko nitrogen deficient soil bhi chal jati hai. So P could be Nepenthes, whereas Q could be Cuscuta. Q could be Cuscuta, leafless and rootless. So what is your answer? P could be Nepenthes, because Nepenthes is the insect trapping plants. Yes, very good study and have fun. Yeah, Q could be Cuscuta. See here, insectivorous plants, Nepenthes, have trapping mechanism designed to catch and digest insects. They derive nitrogen from the insect they trap in. Or that is why they can grow in nitrogen deficient soil, or the leguminous plants can grow there. So leguminous ka option nahi tha, to isse Nepenthes. Second, Cuscuta daughter plant is an obligate or total stem parasite which derives its nutrition from the host. It lacks chlorophyll and has no connection with the soil after the seeding stage. So therefore, it does not have leaf or roots. Yeah, it inserts its stem into the host plant. Yeah, Nepenthes is a pitcher plant. Next question, refer to the given food web. Oh my God. It's a real web. You have to understand it. From where it starts, let us locate. Yeah, everybody is coming up to refer to the given food web. See, oak acorns eaten up by earthworms, red-tailed hawk, then snakes, then earthworm is eaten up by mouse and mouse is eaten up by snake, then earthworm is taken, salamander, and then salamander over here, and then comes the pine tree, then here is the golden crown kinglet, golden crown kinglet, come on. So red-tailed hawk is also taking up the mouse, right? So if a non-biodegradable insecticide known as DDT was sprayed into the pine tree, where is the pine tree? This was the pine tree. Pine tree is here. Pine tree was taken up, pine borer, golden crown kinglet. Pine tree was eaten up by earthworm. Yes. So pine, there are two arrows going, earthworm and also golden crown kinglet by earthworm. So was sprayed into the pine tree, which of the following will most of the DDT eventually accumulate? So, if we are spraying DDT, kis mein zyada accumulate hogi? Dekho, pine tree, pine borer, golden crown kinglet and earthworm. So, in which it will be eventually accumulating? Finally, all are going to snake. All are going to earthworm, then earthworm to again to snake. So, finally, everything, all are coming up over here. So eventually it will accumulate in snake. Very good. Next, in the given food web, snake is the top consumer for the food chain. It's a non-biodegradable compound which gets accumulated in the pine borer, then in the consumers. By accumulation, levels of DDT to the greatest extent is in the top consumer, which is the snake. Next comes, children, these are questions, nearly 4 to 5 questions are such which can go wrong. After listening, they look to be simple, but these are the questions they go wrong, and you need 58 or 59 marks out of 60 to be in top 10. Even if you have to be in top 100, your score should be more than 57 or 58. But easily the children drop down to 40, 45, 50. They land up maximum at 50 if you remember your last year's score. So unless and until you practice, because you will not enhance your thinking, you will not explore unless and until you do the previous year questions. So hormones are produced by organs called endocrine glands. Select the incorrect option about these words. Few words have been italicized. Select the incorrect option about these words. These are ductless glands. Okay, very true. Very small quantity of different hormones is required by our body. Very good. Thyroxine secreted when we are stressed or excited. No, that is adrenal. Liver regulates the sugar metabolism in the body by its hormone insulin. Absolutely wrong. What should be here? What should be here? Yes, insulin ke saath kaun sa gland related hai? Pituitary gland secretes melatonin while parathyroid gland secrete calcitonin. So first of all, your reproductive system chapter and endocrine system should be thorough. Yes. Doesn't matter, guys. Yes. So thyroxine should be replaced by adrenaline. Liver should be replaced with pancreas. Position of pituitary and parathyroid should be interchanged. Pituitary should be replaced by pineal. So which is the correct statement? Position of pituitary and see here. You have to tell which is select the incorrect option. Positions of pituitary and parathyroid should be interchanged. This is incorrect. Rest all are correct. So adrenaline is secreted when the person is stressed. Pancreas regulate the sugar metabolism. Pineal gland secretes melatonin while thyroid gland secretes calcitonin. Very good. Next. 5 questions left. So be there. Supriya wants to carry out just 6 more minutes. A fair test to find out how fast. Children, they are lengthy questions. So when you will practice only then you will have a habit of reading them. And I tell you, chemistry and physics was easier than bio. You need to keep your fingers strong on bio. Supriya wants to carry out a fair test to find out how fast water can pass through equal quantity of 4 different types of soil. She sets up an experiment. She uses stopwatch to measure the time taken by the water through the soil. This is a funnel, cotton wool and collected water measuring cylinder. Time taken, P takes C. She uses to, wants to carry out fair test. Water can pass through equal quantity of 4 different types of soil. She sets up an experiment. Now, pani ko pass karna hai soil se. Here it took 33 seconds. Here it took 23 seconds, 45 seconds, 18 seconds. That means this is most porous. And this is least porous. Because it is taking lot of time. So, let us see which type of soil is suitable to grow paddy. पैडी के लिए कैसा होना चाहिए जो वॉटर रिटेन करे. सो विच काइंड ऑफ अ सॉइल इज गुड फॉर पैडी. कम ऑन आंसर. यस आर विच इज दैट विच इज लीस्ट पोरस. इट विल रिटेन वॉटर. सो इट इज बेस्ट फॉर पैडी. सी सच काइंड ऑफ क्वेश्चन दे आस्क्ड. या दे मिक्स 2 to 3 थिंग्स. So best is paddy. I've already explained. 2 persons X and Y are standing at a distance of 100 meter from a high wall as shown in the figure. When X is given a clap, the time interval between the 2 sounds heard by Y is 0.2 seconds. 2 claps ke beech mein. If speed of the sound is, then the distance D between X and Y is. You know, distance is equal to speed into time. But this time is of coming and going because उसमें आपको echo सुन रहा है, तो आपको time को half करना पड़ेगा. Yes. So what will be your answer? What will be your answer? Distance speed into time. But what will you do with the time? Come on. Yes. You have to find distance between D, then the distance between, distance D between X and Y is. 2 persons X and Y are at 100 meters from a high wall as shown in the figure. When X is given the clap, the time interval between the 2 sounds heard by is 0.2 seconds. Yes. So what is the distance? Yes. It's 270. See how. This is a tricky, again, pick of the day. Again, the pick of the day. This distance is D. This is 100. Sound will go this way. Yeah, strike and come back this way. So, sound is taking 0.2 seconds. So, 0.1 from this side and 0.1 from this side. Total distance, it travels this much. Now, see. This is distance. Time taken by sound to travel from X to Y directly is या टाइम इज डिस्टेंस अपॉन स्पीड, डी अपॉन 330. आफ्टर रिफ्लेक्शन फ्रॉम साउंड रीचेज इट्स ओ एक्स प्लस, दिस इज ओ, ओ एक्स प्लस ओ वाई अपॉन स्पीड. सो यू गेट, दिस इज अ फॉर्मूला. या टाइम टेकन बाय द साउंड वाई फ्रॉम एक्स टू ओ इज 2 स्क्वायर रूट ऑफ डी बाय 2 का होल स्क्वायर प्लस सी. पाइथागोरस थ्योरम यू आर यूजिंग ओवर हियर, राइट? अकॉर्डिंग टू द क्वेश्चन सॉल्विंग इट यू विल गेट 270 मीटर्स. या फिजिक्स इज फाइन बट आई हैव टू वर्क ऑन बायो. यस अंशिका. एंड नेक्स्ट इज द ट्रेमर्स प्रोड्यूस वेव्स ऑन द सर्फेस ऑफ द अर्थ. The tremors produce waves on the surface of the earth. These are called, the tremors produce waves on the surface of the earth, these are called. The waves are recorded by instrument called. Richter scale is a dash scale. Earthquake of magnitude 6 has dash times more destructive energy than earthquake of magnitude 4. So first one, tremors produce waves, these are called as. Earthquake, seismic wave. Then, second, the waves are recorded by instrument called seismograph. So you are sure about these. So you have to select from these two. Richter scale is a linear scale or a non-linear scale. An earthquake of magnitude 6 has 1000 times more destructive energy than or 100 times more. It is non-linear scale and it is 1000 times more. So yes, option C is your answer. Very good, Anshika. You're doing very good. Anshika, are you enrolled for the batches? 3 more questions left, children. Instrument which records waves on the surface of the earth. An earthquake of magnitude 6 has 1000 times more destructive energy than magnitude 4 and it is a non-linear scale. Come on. Ruchi, a science teacher arranged the given apparatus of beaker containing 2 different metal strips of same size fastened together and immersed in hydrochloric acid. Okay. Metal strip of same size immersed in hydrochloric acid. 2 different metal strips, P and Q, they are pasted and dipped in acid. P and Q, R and Q, T and S. So these are different metals. A science teacher arranged. After 50 minutes, we observed that amount of Q ions formed is greater than P ions in beaker 1. Amount of Q is greater than P. That means Q is displaced. That means P is more reactive than Q. Next, S ions is greater than R. S is greater than R. So S is displaced. Yes. So, S is displaced. So, R is greater than S. R ions formed is greater than Q. R is greater than Q. So, R is displaced. And then, S ions in beaker 4. So, more of S ions. So, on the basis of the observation, we can conclude that the most reactive and least reactive metals are respectively. Most reactive and least reactive. Most reactive is T and least reactive is P. Yes. Now see. Look here. Let us see. Inferences. Q, it says that T is highest reactive and P is the least reactive. Why? T is greater than S, is greater than R, greater than Q, greater than P. Ions are formed after. Yes. Let us go back. Sorry. Rui, a science teacher, arranged the given apparatus where each beaker contains 2 different metals. They say Q ions formed is greater than P. Q ke ions zyada hain greater than P. R ions are more than S. And here again, wait 1 minute. R ions is formed greater than Q. R are formed greater than Q. And then T ions is greater than S. T is greater than S. So T is greater than S. Yes. And S is over here. R is greater than S. Then R is greater than Q. And Q is greater than P. So P falls to be the least. And T falls to be the highest reactive. Yes. Next answer. Refer to the given dichotomous key, identify PT and select the option regarding them. It is a unicellular organism. Refer to the given dichotomous key, identify PT and select the correct statement regarding them. Come on, only two questions left. It's a unicellular. Dichotomous key ka hai. Aram se isko padhiyega because you will have to see like it's a unicellular organism. So go to second point. Yeah. And you will have to go to, it's a multicellular, go to fourth. It possesses well-organized nucleus, go to third. It lacks well-organized nucleus, it's P. So third is nutrition is parasitic, nutrition is mixotrophic, possesses chlorophyll, lacks chlorophyll. So P could be slipper animalcule, R could be euglena, Q could be plasmodium, S could be an alga. So you had to tell like which answer is correct. So Q could be plasmodium, which causes malaria, and could be entamoeba, which causes amoebic dysentery. Right. And last question is identify PQRS in the following extinct species, vulnerable, endangered species, PQRS. So this was the last question. You can see from here. And yes, P is C, Q is lion, and R is Nilgiri. And this is the solution to it. So, C means, so this was the last question. So, thank you all, dear children. Yes, thank you all for giving your time. Wonderful, amazing. Thanks to all. Thank you. Bye-bye, all of you. And see you tomorrow again. See you tomorrow.